Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, as we have seen in the previous section, what is boundary layer separation? And what happens due to boundary layer separation is there is negative pressure gradient. Due to this negative pressure gradient, there will be a formation of negative pressure at the end of the body. So let us see what happens when there is a large amount of boundary layer separation in few bodies. Is streamline bodies and bluff. So in order to learn what is streamline body, we need to understand few things about boundary layer. Now, whenever a body is placed in a medium where the air is flowing with certain velocity, there is a point over here which we define as this point as a leading edge. From the point of leading edge, there will be a formation of boundary layer in this part. And as the boundary layer grows with respect to distance x from the leading edge, what happens is there is increase in the increase in the growth of the boundary layer, as well as there will be laminar sub layer formed over here due to the negative pressure gradient. Along with this, whenever a body is kept in influence of a very high velocity, there are two kinds of forces which are acted on the body. First force is which is parallel to the force of the body. This force is called as the drag force. This force will be called as the drag force. The other force is perpendicular to this, will be called as the lift force. Along with that, there is some friction on the surface of the body. So the friction along the surface of the body, so there will be a drag force on this entire part, as well as there will be some lift force. Now over here, when there is some amount of drag force over here, there will be a friction on the surface of this entire body. That friction is called as skin friction. And the second friction will be called as the drag friction, in which this will be perpendicular to the surface. So the friction applied on this surface will slow down the body, whereas the friction on the skin side will be a shear force applied on the body. So these are the two kinds of friction we should understand. That is a drag friction as well as a skin friction. These two frictions are necessary to study what is a streamlined body as well as a bluff body. Before studying streamlined body and bluff body, we already know what are streamlines. Streamlines are the lines which are along the flow of the fluid. So over here, if we consider a body, on this there will be some air flowing over this body with velocity u. While the air is flowing over the body, what happens exactly over there is there is a formation of a boundary layer from the leading edge to the trailing edge. But just near the trailing edge, the boundary layer separation has occurred. Now due to this, there will be some amount of wake formation. Wake formation will result in some amount of drag in the body. So a body which is aligned to the streamlines of the body will be called as a streamline bodies, as well as the wake formation is very small, as well as at the end of that entire body or near to the trailing edge, there will be a formation of wake, or there is a boundary layer separation. Due to this boundary layer separation, there is a formation of wake, as well as there is a frictional drag. Whereas in a bluff body, what happens is the boundary layer separation has already occurred. Now, if I take the same body and put perpendicular to the direction of propagation, what do we get is a body which is kind of this. In this, there, this is a body where the air is flowing over that body. Once it flows, there is a large amount of wake formation over here, due to which the pressure drag on the body is very large, or the drag force on the body is very large. Due to this large amount of drag force, this entire body is dragged in the particular direction. But whereas for a streamlined body, this entire body is not dragged in that particular direction, because it induces only skin friction, not the drag friction. Whereas over here, there is large amount of drag friction as compared to the skin friction. Now, while this wake formation takes place, if we consider the pressure over here as P1 and we consider the pressure over here is P2, what exactly happens over here is P1 is greater than P2. Since the pressure difference is very large over here, this entire large pressure drags the body towards the right direction, due to which there is a large amount of drag force. The best examples of bluff body, we can consider a kite. It is perpendicular to the propagation of the shape of the kite is perpendicular to the propagation of the wind, due to which there is large amount of drag force. Due to the wind velocity, the kite goes behind, and due to lift force which we take, that lifts up the kite in a particular direction. Secondly, one of the example we can take for a bluff body is a body which consists of large amount of wake. There is a large amount of wake in advertising hoardings, where over there, if we see majority of the hoardings, they are actually rectangular in shape. Now, when they are rectangular in shape, the wind blowing perpendicular to the direction of the surface may carry the hoarding with themselves. So there is a large amount of drag force involved in that. Whereas a streamlined body, such as an example of an airplane wing, is aerodynamically designed that it consists of least amount of drag friction as well as the skin friction. Skin friction, of course, we cannot neglect in a streamlined body, but drag friction definitely we can neglect in this body. But there will be small amount of wake formation at the end of the body. But to minimize the small amount of wake formation at the end of the body, we have to design the body which is aerodynamic in design. That is called a body which is aerodynamically designed, where the boundary layer separation at the end of the surface is negligible, is called as an aerofoil. So we'll study aerofoil in detail, but for now we have seen what is a streamlined body as well as bluff body. So I hope you have understood what is a streamlined body and bluff body and applications of streamlined body in real life situations. Thank you.